In 1900, China was a divided nation, dominated by foreign powers, and ruled by a dowager empress. By 2000, it was an economic world power. Several factors helped in this evolution. Americans' treatment of the Chinese was one of them. In the 1850s, thousands of Chinese immigrants had emigrated to America. First, to prospect for gold, then to help build the Transcontinental Railroad. Here, they often suffered discrimination, harassment, and frequent brutality. Fear and hatred of the Chinese immigrants led to several mass killings, as mobs of white men swept into Chinese settlements and slaughtered the inhabitants. China heard of the harsh treatment, racist policies, and the American government's recurring violation of treaties with that country. Of a plague that began in San Francisco, and how the Chinese were quarantined in Chinatown, though white citizens allowed to freely pass in and out. Of the passage of the Chinese Exclusion Act, the only time America prevented immigration and naturalization on the basis of race. Of the 1902 Boston immigration raid that rounded up 234 Chinese Americans who couldn't immediately produce their papers for the immigration agents. They were brutally handled and locked in a communal cell. Of immigration authorities denying an American-born man of Chinese ancestry entry back into the U.S. Chinese in San Francisco asked their countrymen back home to pressure America into giving better treatment to Chinese immigrants. The Chinese government didn't act, but on May 5, 1905, the Shanghai Chamber of Commerce did. It announced it would boycott all American goods. It might have been simply an empty gesture, except that the movement spread. Chinese cities in 12 other provinces joined the boycott. Chinese merchants stopped carrying American cigarettes, cotton, and flour. Boats refused to carry American goods. The movement also drew support from the Philippines, Singapore, Japan, Hong Kong, and Hawaii. The boycott lasted about a year. Ultimately, merchants realized they couldn't survive without American products. Also, the Chinese government, wanting to stay on good terms with a powerful U.S., pressured merchants to drop the boycott. However, it created a lasting feeling of solidarity across the country and at all levels of Chinese society. It aided the Chinese national movement, which unified the country to rid itself of foreign domination, and ultimately led the country to its current global prominence.